Let's take a look here. After the humoral and cell mediated immunity, which we learned, just we have individual issues that let us learn the cells of immune system. Okay, cells of immune system. There are T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes. We call them as lymphocytes. Okay, next, phagocytes, axillary cells. Lymphocyte, phagocyte, and axillary cells. Okay, these are all the cells of immune system. Let's take a look on lymphocyte. Lymphocytes are of two types, B cell and T cells. The B cells, when the microbe they get attacked, that means when they exposed to the microbe, antigenic portion, they differentiated into plasma cell and memory cell. The plasma cells are the short-lived and they act at the immediately they act on the microbe, and memory cells are said to be long-lived memory cells. That means in future time, when the same microbe, when it enters in the body, they respond. I hope you are understanding well because of our previous class. We discussed a lot about the humoral immunity. The same thing here, it is given in the form of the B cells. Okay. Then when it comes to the T lymphocytes, The T lymphocytes are of two types, T helper cells and T, the cytotoxic cells. The T helper cells are having the cluster differentiating molecules, the CD4 molecules, we use it to say here, the cluster differentiating molecules on the cell surface, CD4 molecules are present, hence they are also called T4 cells. Here the cluster differentiating molecules, CD8 molecules are present in case of T cytotoxic cell. That's why we call them as T8 cells. So it was shown like that only. T4, nothing but T helper cell. And T8, due to the cluster differentiating CD8 molecule, that we call T8. We know that their properties and their activities. The T helper cell, they are responsible for either humoral immunity or cell mediated. How? They collect the microbe from MHC class 2 and they submit either to the B lymphocyte for humoral immunity or T cytotoxic cells for cell mediated immunity. I hope you are not understand that you are not feeling new anything here, because we have completed that MHC in the previous class along with humoral cell mediated. That's why I said over MHC learning, MHC table, whatever I shown here now, that MHC table, learning the table is very, very important. Wherever we go, their fruits of MHC will come here like this. That this is the MHC complex molecules we learned in the first class. As what I said now, the T helper cell may submit to the antigen to T cytotoxic cell for cell mediated immunity, or may submit the antigen to the B lymphocytes for humoral immunity. So that means whatever we are here, T cytotoxic cell. The T cytotoxic cell will collect either from altered cell, or they may collect either from T helper cell. They are responsible for cell mediated immunity. Okay, so whatever we learned there, the same which we are observing here in the previous class. Okay, so that's it. Now, the T cytotoxic cell. So what to say about the T cytotoxic cell? They are responsible for cell mediated immunity, from where they collect the microbe, either from ASC, altered cell, or either from APC indirectly via T helper cell. Okay, so that's it. That's what I shown now in the MHC class. So that's why our first class is very, very important. That about the immune system, humoral and cell mediated. I hope you understand now why I explained humoral and cell mediated and MHC first, then the remaining things. Okay, so this is the story which we already learned just now. A formality is shown to you. Now the phagocytes. Phagocytes, mononuclear phagocytes and polymorphonuclear phagocytes. Mononuclear phagocytes. So let me remind you once that blood, what you learned in earlier classes. Blood, about the blood. We said granulocytes are of three types. Eosinophil, basophil, neutrophil. A granulocytes are of two types, lymphocyte and monocytes in the blood, in WBC. We said the WBC is of two, granulocytes and a granulocyte. So we are talking about these monocytes now, the granulocytes of the WBC. the monocytes, which are called as mononuclear phagocytes. These monocytes, when they become active, we call them as macrophages. When they become active, we call them as macrophages. And these macrophages, when they are settled down in the areolar or connective tissue, we call them as histiocytes or wandering macrophages. Kupffer cells, when they settle in liver, Kupffer cells. In the brain, microglial cell. In the osteoclast, bone. Wherever you go. So first of all, the story, history, you need to understand. It's a monocyte. When it become active, we call them as macrophages. And these macrophages will go in different places of the body. And they settle down. Wherever they go, they do one function. What is that? Phagocytosis. Their activity is only one, always, that is phagocytosis. Okay, so these phagocytosis is done in the areolar connective tissue by macrophages. We call the cells as histiocytes. Migrating macrophages will come there, wandering macrophages. In the liver, the same cells called Kupffer cells. In the brain, microglial cell. In the bone, osteoclast cell. In the lungs, alveolar cells. Likewise, wherever they do the same function. That is phagocytosis. Polymorphonuclear phagocytes. Neutrophil, basophil, eosinophils. We call polymorphonuclear phagocytes. But mostly 62% neutrophils only present here in a granulocyte. So that's why we are giving credit of polymorphonuclear phagocytes to neutrophils only. Okay. So that's it about the polymorphonuclear phagocytes. These are most common. Basophils, we know that go for inflammation, responsible for inflammation. Eosinophils will end in first year, allergic response. Okay, next, the auxiliary cells. These are auxiliary cells. Can cells that help lymphocytes in immune response? How do they help? How do they help? They secrete inflammatory mediators and cause inflammatory response. Okay, so basophils and mast cells are responsible for the that releasing the inflammatory mediators like histamine, heparin, bradykinin, serotonin, prostaglandins. All these are going to release there, and they are responsible for the inflammatory response. Inflammatory response. Then we have next antigen presenting cells. So we learned about the antigen presenting cell, which are having MHC class 2, isn't it? MHC class 2. The macrophages, B cells, dendritic cells, they are all said to be the antigen presenting cell, which they are presenting the antigen to the T helper cell, which the helper cell may present it to the T cytotoxic cell for cell mediated or to the B lymphocytes to the humoral immunity. So that is a story of cells of immune system. Okay. Now, let's move forward. Let's move forward. Here, it's given about the activity of the life history of the lymphocyte. Because T and B lymphocytes are very important for us, as we are discussing from the beginning. Their production, their maturation, when they get activated, they're all the story. Okay. Earlier in the previous classes, we are seeing the stem cells, isn't it? We remember, we said hematopoietic stem cells differentiated into lymphoid stem cells. And that lymphoid stem cells are going to form. That hematopoietic stem cell which are located in the red bone marrow. So these hematopoietic stem cells which are going to differentiate in the form of lymphoid stem cells, that stem cells of bone marrow in adult mammals, we simply say the production of both B and T lymphocytes in the red bone marrow by the stem cell. Which stem cell? Hematopoietic stem cell, which differentiated into lymphoid stem cell. Both the T and B. Okay. Then, that is called production. But when you talk about the other exceptions, like in fetal stages, the same work is done by liver, actually. In case of birds, that pneumatic bones they are. Bird bones are pneumatic, air-filled bones, isn't it? So that's why that instead of bone marrow, that bursa fabricius took the role for the production of B lymphocytes. Okay. So then, let's talk about the human being. When you talk about the human being, the production occurs at the B and T lymphocytes. Both are going to be produced at the hematopoietic stem cells of the red bone marrow, which were differentiated into lymphoid stem cells. Okay. What next? What makes the maturation? The B lymphocyte maturation occur in the same place where they produce. That means in the bone marrow. But the T lymphocytes will migrate from there and move to the special gland called thymus, which is an endocrine gland. If you remember, we said that is in the ventral side of the thoracic region near the heart. There is a gland, we said thymus gland, which releases a hormone called thymosin. And thymosin responsible for the maturation of the T lymphocytes, which are produced in the red bone marrow. They have to migrate from the bone marrow. Then they should come to the thymus gland, and that means they should be influenced by the thymosin hormone released by thymus gland, and then the hormone makes that particular maturation. So I think you came to know why the names are given like that. B means bone marrow lymphocyte. Okay, T means thymic lymphocyte. Thymic, that means the name is given not by the production basis. It is given by the maturation basis. Okay, where production and maturation occurs, we call such an organs are called primary lymphoid organs. They are called primary lymphoid organs. That means whatever the listed things here, all are primary lymphoid organs. That's it. That what we are listed here, the total, the bone marrow and liver and fetal stage, but the fibrillations of birds, and thymus, all these are where those are helpful for production as well as maturation. We call them as primary lymphoid organs. We say that as primary lymphoid organs. Okay, next, secondary lymphoid organ. Okay, we use a word called immune competent cell. After the maturation, the T and B lymphocytes are called immune competent cells. Immune competent cells. Okay, so these immune competent cells, what do you call these immune competent cells, are going to be B and T lymphocytes. What they do, they are ready to fight. Where they should fight, to whom they should fight, they are, that means they need to fight with the microbes who are entering into the body. So that means we need to make them into specific places where there is a possibility of the entry of microbes. So that places which we have noticed here, like spleen, lymph nodes, tonsils, Peyer's patches of small intestine, that and appendix, that these are all said to be that secondary lymphoid organ where our immune competent B and immune competent T cells are ready to fight. And in their fields, like cell-mediated immunity, their mode of killing is different, and the mode of killing of humoral immunity by B lymphocyte is different. So that the certain activity is done in the spleen, in the lymph nodes, in the tonsils, in the Peyer patches of small intestine. Remember, this is very important. Peyer patches of small intestine and appendix, all these are going to be that we call secondary lymphoid organs and tissues. Okay, simply we can use a word called mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue. Mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue. That means the trachea contain the mucus lining and the intestine contain the mucus lining. Okay, so that mucosa layer we are talking about. Wherever the mucosa layer is there our T and B will go and they settle here. They settle and they try and stop working. That means the activity of microbes, they are going to stop. Okay, so that's what we say activation. So simply, you remember this. Where production and maturation occur, that is primary lymphoid organ. And the primary lymphoid organs are that liver in fetal stage, bursa fabricius of birds, and red bone marrow, and the thymus. All this is said to be primary lymphoid organ. Where the activation occurs, that organs are called secondary lymphoid organs, and spleen, lymph nodes, tonsils, Peyer's patches of small intestine and appendix are said to be a secondary lymphoid organ where activation takes place. So that's the story of that. The production, maturation and activation of T and B lymphocytes. Okay, now let's move to the next page. I hope all you got this page, that PDF. It is all there with you. So then next phase next phase. Here we have to go. Okay, so just we talked about the antibodies already. Antibodies, that antibodies, what do you call, para two, that you better remember that para two in the earlier classes. That what I said, that if you take an antibody, that there are two portions, FC and FAB, and this portion where it is going to change accordingly to the microbial antigen. The portion where it can bind with antigen is said to be para two. Site where antigen binds, that what you call para two. Okay, site where antigen open, that we say para two. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I got some small disturbance here. So let me open this back again. Yeah. Okay. So that we just talked about that antibody story earlier. Antibody, that para two, the site where antigen binds. What do you call the para two? Okay. Site where antigen binds. So here, the free antibodies, we just talked about this also. Free antibodies are present in the fluids. Free antibodies are present in the fluids. And some of the antibodies are going to connect, attach to the help of their FC and to the B cells or to the mast cells, that either to the B lymphocyte or mast cells or basophils, they are going to attach. So what we call that surface antibodies present on the surface of mature and memory B cells. Okay, so and also the mast cells are accommodating this particular. The mast cells are also doing. Okay, next about that's all about the antibodies. We discussed it earlier. Okay, now let's talk about cytokines, the communication language of this particular immune system. Interleukins, they are produced by the leukocytes. They're primarily involved in the differentiation of the cells of immune system. Then example they are given, for before we go to that example, we need to see practically how that interleukins are going to communicating and making the differentiation and activation. So have you seen, we have seen this earlier. You see here, the T helper cell released a particular interleukin. That interleukin is making that T cytotoxic cells to be differentiated into T effector cells and T memory cells. So what it means, that is the communication. T helper cell is communicating how they are talking each other, that with the help of a kind of cytokine, what do you say, interleukin. There are so many interleukins are there, IL-1, IL-2, with various activities. Simply you people need to remember here that interleukins are the communication language between the immune competent cells. Immune competent cells just talk in between them. Their activity is done by interleukins. Okay, so that means differentiation is possible by interleukins. Or simply you remember their language, their communication language. Okay, so let me get back into the same place where we left over about the soluble mediators of immunity. We are talking about interleukin, and you see some of the interleukins reaches the brain. That means particularly hypothalamus, where it regulates the temperature of the body and causes the fever response. That means what is fever response? That means asking help of the brain, that when they are fighting with the microbe, when they feel so there are so many microbes are there from the B lymphocytes or T lymphocyte, that interleukin 1 will be released over and goes to the brain. Brain, please raise the body temperature. It's just like just into your home, there, imagine you cook very well. That's why that so many people are coming as a guest every day. Some 10, 15 number of people are coming. You became so famous. Okay, so you don't know how to solve the problem here. You cook well. That's why the guests are coming without invitation. So what we need to do? just purchase 1 kg salt extra. That within a period of time, that guest entry will be stopped. So what I am saying here, that making the people are comfortable, they feel that tasteful, they feel that they are coming. Okay, so let make it a little salty, the food material. Use 1 kg salt on every dish. That's over. Okay, so that's it. The same plan we are doing. What's the plan? That 37 degrees centigrade is our body temperature, and microbes are the guest of our guest microbacteria, viruses, seasonal infections in general. You see here in one particular season, rainy season, suddenly fever will come. Okay, so what is this exactly? So many bacteria and virus came inside. So that's why we are increasing our body temperature 2-3 degrees centigrade, so that make us our guests to kill at a time. Not by the weapon T and B, just simply we can kill at a time. So that means fever is also a kind of immunological response. So that is done by interleukin 1, reaches to the brain and causes a fever response. That's what we are talking here. Okay, it's just like making unsuitable atmosphere to the microbes which are entered in bulk amounts, which we can kill them at a time by increasing our body temperature. Okay, next, interferons. Interferons, very interesting cells here. These are, imagine this is a body cell. Okay, into this body cell a virus is attacked. Okay, so virus is attacked. Virus means nothing but RNA substance, isn't it? So virus is attacked. So our cells are fighting against the virus. They show the defense against the virus. So this virally infected cell, after all fighting with this particular microvirus, they release a antiviral protein. What is that? Interferon. Okay, this interferon released from the virally infected cell. This is virally infected cell. Excuse me. So released from the virally infected cell goes to the healthy cell. But for what? The protein goes to the healthy cell for what? To provide the information of the virus. Okay, so that interferons are released from the virally infected cell, and the protein which reaches to the healthy cell, this is the healthy cell which I am showing. Okay, so that means before the microbe comes, we are giving some knowledge to the healthy cells of our body by releasing interferon. Okay, so that's what, let us say, produced by virally infected cell, antiviral protein it is, interferon, involved in protecting the neighboring cell from the viruses of infected cell. And basically there are three types of interferon: alpha, beta, gamma. Three types of interferons are there. Gamma interferons are so famous, and they are used like vaccine type structures even. Okay, so then let's talk about the complement proteins. A very interesting issue here, the complement proteins. Okay, so these complement proteins, these are inactive plasma proteins. Actually, these are inactive plasma proteins, which are associated with the cell surface proteins, we can say here. Okay, so that means you may know the cell is made up of lipoprotein membrane, lipid ocean with protein iceberg. Just like that, these plasma proteins are also present that on the cell surface, that are in the plasma. Okay, so these inactive plasma proteins, which are going to associate with the cell surface proteins, when they activated, they form membrane attack complex. Let me show you that membrane attack complex. That interestingly, that particular membrane attack complex. Let me show you, then after we'll get back. Here it is. Let me zoom this area only. Wait a minute. Here it is. Talking about the complement system. So this complement system is inactive plasma proteins, we say. Then when activated, they're going to contact with the cell surface protein and form the membrane attack complex. Imagine this is a bacterium. So this is a bacterium. Okay, so this complement protein form a membrane attack complex, which makes the hole just puncture the cell membrane of the bacterium. Okay, so what it can happen, that what can be the result then? when it was punctured cell membrane, lot of fluid into the body, it will spread over, lot of fluid will enter into the body, isn't it? So that fluid enters and blasts that particular microbe, a kind of killing. What do you say? A kind of killing. Okay, so complement proteins are even activated by antibodies. So generally in active status they are present, but when they activated, the complement protein form a membrane attack complex which makes a hole, pore nothing but hole, and that makes the flow of ECF, and the microbe is bursting out. You see, oh my god, it just crossed out, burst out and went out. Yeah, this is the microbe with a lot of holes. Our body fluid entered into the microbe and blasted up. So a kind of killing, a complement proteins. Okay, so that's it, that's about the story of this particular complement protein. Let me erase this and we'll move forward. We'll go back. The complement protein, and now let's read the theory, what is given about the complement protein. It's a little, I think, should have started. Okay, no. Here it is, we came back. Yeah, well, now let us read, we'll understand. The visual we have in brain, inactive plasma protein plus cell surface protein, when activated, they form a membrane attack complex, forms pores in the plasma membrane of the affected cell. It allows ECF to enter the cells and make them swell and burst. That's it. This is up to here, we have seen the story. Okay, so there is another activity. Some of them form the coat on the surface of pathogen. A pathogen came, and what they do, some of the complement protein will form the coat on the pathogen. Okay, surface of pathogen, they form a coat. This is the bacteria, the red one I'm showing. Now the complement protein form a coat and attract the neutrophil and macrophages for what? For what? Opsonization. Did you remember opsonization? What I said about the opsonization? So this is called opsonization. As I said to you earlier, I'll remind you once again. Okay, so what is opsonization? There is a person called B. You want to hit B, you are D. So you want to hit D. Okay, so how you are taken that with your friends A and C, that A and C hold the B and you now able to hit him properly. Okay, so that what A and C are doing, they are doing opsonization, making bacteria more susceptible for phagocytosis. So this is a neutrophil. So that we are making bacteria more susceptible. Opsonization. Just simply I am saying here, your two friends holding the enemy's right and left hand, and you went there and you did whatever the activity you want to do. What you call your friends which are holding the enemy's hand is called opsonization. Okay. So all these are under one roof, what do you call them as soluble mediators of immunity. Complement proteins, cytokines like interleukins and interferons, and antibodies, all these are available in the blood plasma. That's why we call them as soluble mediators of immunity. Okay. So then under the roof, soluble mediators of immunity, we learn the complement proteins, cytokines like interleukin and interferon, and then the antibodies. Okay. Now, moving on, actually, after all listening to this total story, you may get confused over that. So, the complement proteins are killing, antibodies killing, lymphocytes are killing. So, if this much number, why this much number of people? Why this much number of people? Police can kill, CRPF army can do the protection, then CRPF people can do, that Navy people do, what all these are, the same doubt may come for you that we are now putting all the land issues in an order now. This is the climax. Okay, which when you go to the textbook, this is the first page. So I made in my order that it is the last page. We learned lot of killing stories. We are just putting them in an order. So one thing you need to remember here, when a microbe enters in the body, immediately we know our heroes won't come. That who are our heroes, the T lymphocyte and B lymphocyte. They don't come immediately. Okay, they are heroes. But in between the time, they need to cross the levels. Okay, that levels we are talking. The first line of defense, second line of defense, third line of defense. That means total immune activity we classified into three. First line, second line, third. The first line of immunity, skin. Skin is the largest organ of the body. Okay, so what skin can do? Skin stop the microbes, that's all. No mechanism at all. Just stop the microbes, that's all. It's a wall of our body. That's why we can say that is a physical barrier. Chiefly act as a physical barrier. Okay. So do it have memory? That do it remember? Do it have any memory cells? No, nothing at all. That's why we say that kind of immunity called non-specific line and very fast reacting response. Isn't it? So it stops that cell. Okay, likewise, lysosome, which is there in the sweat, in the mucus secreted by the wall of gut, in saliva, in tears, the lysozyme is present, which you may know this within in digestion also, that kills the bacterial cell wall, but damages the cell wall of the bacteria. Okay, so which bacteria? Any bacteria. That's why we say that is non-specific line. It even don't remember that bacteria. Any bacteria come, they dissolve the cell wall. That's all. They dissolve the cell wall. Okay. So that dissolution of cell wall is possible by them. Next, that sebum. Low pH of the sebum, which is present in the sebaceous glands, released by sebaceous glands on our skin. Okay, that also kill the microbes. Mucous membranes are also going to stop the microbes. So that what do you see? So these lysozyme, sebum, what these are? These are all physiological barriers. So skin is a physical barrier and lysozyme is a sebum are said to be the physiological barrier. Okay. So next, the second line of defense. That means when they cross this particular skin, lysozyme, sebum, when even after that, if any microbe survive, that will be sent into the second line. Antimicrobial proteins. I don't think so. That is new for you. Antimicrobial proteins. As we have seen that so many times, that antimicrobial proteins. Okay. So produced by the epithelial layers of the different parts of the body, that antimicrobial proteins, which are in the second line. These are also very fast and no specific, no memory at all. The microbe entering the body through inhaled air are caught by the mucus of the bronchioles and bronchi of the respiratory system. And mucus along with the killed microbes are swept out by the ciliature of lining of epithelium by coughing or by sneezing. We send them in a rapid speed, 120 kilometers per hour. So what do you say that as that is also a kind of activity to kill the microbe. And our macrophages, tissue fixed, wandering macrophages, Kupffer cell, that microglial cell that we are seeing so many. And natural killer cells. Natural killer cells simply act like T lymphocytes. That means making whole perforations, releasing the grand genes and making the blasting of cell, all everything like T-cytotoxic cell, but only thing here, they are non-specific. Very fast reacting response. They can't recognize actually any microbe. They can't recognize. But if we show that microbe, that definitely they'll kill that particular microbe. That means here a mediation required over. Some mediation required over. Natural killer cells are individually cannot recognize, some mediation required over, and they're non-specific. Okay, it is said to be non-natural killer cells is very, very effective against the cancer cells. The cancer cells are infected cells of even our body cells, but they are infected cells. These natural killer cells will effectively work on the cancer-affected cells that blast the cancer cells, like perforin, grand genes, caspases. Did you remember? Like cell-mediated immunity, they're going to blast it. High temperature, now only we discussed, fever is also a kind of immunological response. Inflammatory response, collar, dollar, rubor, tumor, which we learned earlier. Collar, dollar, rubor, tumor. These four activities we call inflammatory activities. So that also a kind of second line of defense, immunological response. So when we fail, when all these defense mechanisms are failed, then the story comes to the third line, which is highly specific but takes several days time to become fully functional. Why it will take time? That we know. Why it will is taking time? We have to prepare memory cells. We have to simply we say that we need to prepare key for that particular microbe. So that's why it may take some time, but that what is the advantage of these response of these cells? we have will get memory again is there. Okay, that's it about the third line of defense. You need to remember here straight away when microbe enters in the body, straight away we are going to our T and B lymphocytes will come. It doesn't matter, like so. There are so many ways we are going to stop that microbe, but after all the failure of all that issues, only we will come into that our T and B lymphocytes. Then do remember you once again, first and second lines are very fast, non-specific. And the third line of defense is said to be that with T and B lymphocytes, is said to be highly specific, but takes several days to become fully functional and memory cells are present in them. Okay. Next, finally, innate immunity, acquired immunity. Innate, the immunity which comes by birth, we are going to say it as innate immunity. Immunity inborn or present at the time of birth. What are the immune issues that all we have seen earlier now in the previous table? Like skin, like mucous membrane, HCl in the stomach, saliva in the mouth, the tears from the eyes which contain lysozyme and blood cells. Okay, all these have come by birth. Okay, isn't it? Neutrophil, monocyte, natural killer cell, macrophages, that will come from the parents, it will come by birth itself, they are present. What do you call all of them as? Innate immunity. Just we made separation of them. Physical barriers like skin and mucous membrane, physiological barriers like HCl in the stomach, saliva in the mouth, and tears from the eyes, cellular barriers like neutrophils, polymorphonuclear leukocytes, we call them as neutrophil, monocytes, natural killer cell, activated monocytes called macrophages. Next, cytokine barriers like interferon, all they are considered as by birth they came. Innate, we can say. Okay, innate. Okay, if you take over that everything like HCl in the stomach, what is HCl in the stomach? It is a physiological barrier. It belongs to innate immunity. Okay, it belongs to innate immunity. Okay, so what is the line of defense? That is the first line of defense. So you need to understand in that particular manner. Okay, so that means if you take interferon, what is interferon? Interferon is a cytokine barrier. Interferon is a cytokine barrier. Individual analyzation I'm talking. Interferon belongs to innate immunity. Interferon is a cytokine barrier. Interferon belongs to the second line of defense. Interferon belongs to second line of defense. Not there here, but just saying. Okay. So in that way, you need to understand here. Only gamma interferons belongs to third line. Alpha and beta belongs to second line. That means there is no memory that we have to put it. Let's take with a known example, tears from the eyes, which contain lysosome. What is this? It is a physiological barrier. And it belongs to innate immunity. Okay. And it is there in which line? It is there in the first line of defense. Okay, in that way you have to recognize. In that way you have to analyze that particular issues. Okay, now that about the innate immunity we have seen, non-specific line does not depend on prior contact with microbes. Okay, then acquired immunity. Immunity which will come by birth. We call acquired immunity. The immunity will come by birth. Okay. So in the earlier class, we have seen a story like when 1,000 microbes entered in the body, our B lymphocyte will take some 10 number of microbes, we analyze and we produce certain kind of antibodies. Along with that, we produce memory cells, we recognize them. In the story, if you remember, in the story, what we said, B lymphocytes are activated, but the first time the production of antibodies is going to be late. That because we need to understand what type of antigen it is. But second time, because of memory cells, when the same microbes enters in the body, we immediately kill before their multiplication. First time, microbe may win the game, but that we don't get it for second time, the disease. Why? Because our memory cells will recognize them immediately and will kill. The story which is shown here. The immunity, acquired immunity. Acquired means which we end, whatever we end in the lifetime by the exposure of the various types of microbes. we call acquired. Okay, so active acquired immunity, passive acquired immunity, which we can classify. Acquired immunity can be classified into two: active acquired immunity and passive acquired immunity. Then in active acquired immunity, natural, that means that our said story, 1,000 microbes are entered naturally. Active, our immune system became active against that microbe. Acquired, we developed some memory cells. Okay, so that what you got? You got the immunological memory, like for smallpox, for chickenpox, for various kinds of diseases. Once we get the disease, we don't get it for second time. That what you say, natural, active, acquired immune. Okay, nowadays you may see the COVID cases also. That once we get the disease, there is less possibilities or no possibility. Some registered over one or two. But here, if you have adequate number of memory cells and antibodies, people are saying antibodies directly. That is actually memory cells. If you have enough number of memory cells which are able to produce the antibodies, what it means that you don't get it for second time. Less number of memory cells and antibodies if they are present, then only there is a possibility to get over. Okay. But in general, we are taking a statement, once we get the disease, we don't get it for second time. Okay, next. So now what they are trying to do actually, vaccination. What is vaccination? This is vaccination, you see here. Artificial. We make the same microbe or weakened microbe. Okay, entry of microbe. That means if you want to prepare vaccine against the COVID case, you need to take the COVID virus itself into the body. So that's why that is going to be dangerous here. Without experiments, without laboratory experiments, without the practical experiment, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, why all these? You are going to inject the virus itself. But in what condition? Weakened condition. Okay. So if they're less weakened, what happens? We don't respond. If they're more weak, more active, we get for disease. Okay, that's the problem here. So in a balanced way, they have to prepare. Entry of microbe is artificial. We are making them to enter into the body. So what happens? Our immune system will become active. What we develop? That we develop immunological memory. We acquire. Okay, so here even not getting the disease for first time by taking weakened microbes, we develop memory cells. So that what do you say? Vaccination, the process called. So technically it is called vaccination, artificial, active, acquired immunity. We have seen natural, active, acquired immunity. When microbes come naturally, we develop memory cells. But we are introducing the microbe into our body. What do you say? Artificial, active, acquired immunity. Okay. Next. Passive acquired immunity. It's there in the name. Passive. What is passive? Immune system is not at all active. Okay. So, that you may heard now that people are giving in the newspapers that donate plasma, which contain antibodies against the virus. Okay, donate plasma for antibodies. Okay, what is this? You just see this. This is optically it will show. Artificial entry of antibodies is artificial. Why? Because your immune system, the old age people, the immune system is inactive. That's why we are collecting antibodies from other people. We are giving to them. Okay, so we have some examples here: anti-tetanus, anti-rabies serum, anti-venom serum for snake venom. But nowadays that became a bigger example, COVID cases also, that where the person's patient immune system is not at all responding, we'll collect antibodies from outside. Artificially, we are collecting from outside. So that's why that what do you say? Entry of antibodies is artificial. Because that artificial, where that patient is not producing. That's why there is no immunological memory in case. Okay. So that's it. Natural. What is natural? This is one and only example we have for natural. The newborn baby immune system is also inactive, isn't it? But the mother, through the mother's milk, colostrum, mother's milk, that mother is sending antibodies in initial days after the pasteurization, that initial days of the milk. We discussed this in embryonic development. So that now what I'm saying technically the procedure called natural, because the mother antibodies which are produced in the mother, passive to the baby we are sending, because the immune system of the baby is inactive. And what you acquire? No acquirement. The child won't get any immunological memory because child is not fighting. Mother is sending the antibodies. Okay, so that what do you say? Colostrum. So that's it about that acquired immunity, natural active acquired immunity, artificial active acquired immunity, natural passive acquired immunity, artificial passive acquired immunity. This is the four types. We get a very regular question from here, so just be careful that we can remember this with keywords. Once we get the disease, we don't get it for second time. That what do you say? Natural active acquired immunity. We don't get even for the first time by making the microbes in artificial entry into the body. We can microbe artificial entry. What do you say? Artificial active acquired. Our immune system is not at all working, and we are taking antibodies from outside, which are prepared after that outside. That what do you say? Artificial active acquired, passive acquired immunity. That antibodies from the mother to the newborn baby. What do you say? Natural passive acquired immunity. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so that's it. The story of acquired immunity. Then this is the end of immunology. That means basic issues of the immunology were completed. Associated with the immunology, that AIDS, that hepatitis, that some diseases are there. AIDS, hepatitis, and cancer biology. That we are going to learn. Okay, so I hope, I suggest you to repeat this again and again. Repeat this again and again. Okay, then we are ending the immunology.